What follows is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 49 and 50, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded during the summer of 1966 in New York.
Now, Lord Sri Krishna is just trying to play Arjuna in the platform of working on pure consciousness. We have already discussed for so many days that we are not this dull body, but we are consciousness. Now, somewhere or other, we are in contact with this matter. Therefore, our freedom is checked. As spiritual beings, we are free, free to act, free to have anything, pure, no contamination, no disease, no birth, no death, no old age. And besides that, we have got many, many other qualifications in our spiritual life. So, unfortunately, because we are in contact with this matter, we are hampered in so many ways. This we should understand. And this is the opportunity. This human life is the only opportunity. If we miss this opportunity, then it may be that in our next life we may not have again this nice, civilized human form of life according to our karma. But one thing is sure, you will be glad to hear that once begun, this process of spiritual realization, one is guaranteed to have next life as human being. You will find in the Bhagavad Gita that Suchinam simatam gihi yoga nasta yoga bhrasta samyayati. We find in course of this discussion with Arjuna and Krishna, when Krishna will describe about the yoga system, how to act it. This is also yoga system, yoga sattvakarmani. This is karma yoga. This is karma yoga. So any yoga, either karma yoga or dhyana yoga or jnana yoga, any system of yoga, once begun in this life, that will continue. That will continue. Yogastha kuru karmahi. Srimad Bhagavat says, tattva sadhanmam charanambujam hare, patit tatu jivi bhajan napakotha tatra kuva abhatra abhut amushakin kuva priyadha apta abhajatang sadhanamataha. This is a speech by Narada to his disciple Srila Vyasa, that you should try people to connect them in spiritual life, in conducting spiritual life. It doesn't matter even if he fails to complete the course, still he is not loser. still he is not loser. He, the whole system of Vedic knowledge, especially the Krishna philosophy, Krishna philosophy is the whole philosophy. Vedic knowledge means Krishna philosophy. Vedaishya sarvai aham eva vedyam. The all Vedic knowledge, all Vedic wisdom means to understand Krishna philosophy. That's all. Nothing else. The Krishna philosophy in different ways all over the world, they have been described according to the time, place and people, but you must know the whole thing is Krishna philosophy. Krishna philosophy is, when we speak of Krishna, you don't take this word, Sanskrit word Krishna, in a sectarian meaning. Krishna means the supreme, the highest pleasure. So now, Yogastha, in the previous verse, we have been advised to what? Continue what? Being situated in yoga. And in the next slope, Lord Krishna says, Durena hi avaram karma buddhi yoga dhananjaya buddhau saranam mannicca kripana salahitava. Durena. By force, just like unwanted things which we don't like, we throw it aside. Suppose something is given to me in my during my dinner which I don't like, sometimes we throw it. I don't find it. Is it? Similarly, our discrimination is the best part of Veda. Simply we have to learn how to discriminate whether we are working on material platform or on the spiritual platform. That's all. Just like Arjun was being advised to work on the spiritual platform. That's all. The whole instruction of Bhagavad Gita is based on this principle, that Arjun was perplexed with material thoughts and Lord Krishna wanted to pose him or to place him in the spiritual platform. That's all. So now, from Arjun's activity, you can understand that what is spiritual platform and what is material platform. Now, those who have studied Bhagavad Gita up to the end, and I hope some of you have already read Bhagavad Gita. Arjun was a military man, and Krishna was trying to induce him to his duty as military man, that he must fight. But Arjuna was declined that I cannot kill my relatives, my friends, my brother, my teacher, my grandfather. That was his consideration. But this consideration is material fact. When we think of in relation with this body, that is material fact. Anything done in consideration of this body means senses. The body means the senses. That means anything which we do for sense gratification, that is material. And anything which we do for the satisfaction of the Supreme, that is spiritual fact. That's it. So we have to discriminate whether I am working for sense gratification or whether I am working for the satisfaction of the Supreme. If this art we can learn, then our life becomes spiritualized. Spiritual life does not mean that we have to change something of these activities which are already here. Or our form of the body will change to something extraordinary. Nothing. The same body, the same feature, the same activity, same engagement, everything same. But we have to know the art, whether these activities are being done from the spiritual platform or from the material platform. If we can discriminate in that way, as Lord Krishna advises Arjuna, Durena Javadam Karma Buddhi Yoga Dhananjaya. Oh Dhananjaya, Dhananjaya is the another name of Arjuna. My dear Dhananjaya, Buddhi Yoga, by your intelligence. And as you have explained, Buddhi Yoga means devotional service to the Lord. So, on the criterion of Buddhi Yoga, on the criterion of devotional service to the Lord, you have to do everything. That is the, technique. That is the technique. Durena Jhavaram Karma Buddhi Yoga. Buddhi Yoga. You have to use your intelligence, whether I am doing this on the platform of pure consciousness or on the platform of this body. Now in the beginning, you require a guide. Without guide, it is not possible. Anything which you want to learn in the beginning, any art or science, you require a guide. Without guide, just like a small child, when he begins to walk, he requires the help of his elder brother, or sister, or father, or mother to catch, and one step. But when he begins to walk independently, then he doesn't require any help. Similarly, to learn this art, whether I am acting on the spiritual platform or on the material platform, you require a spiritual master, guide. And this is called bija, or the second bar. When you catch hold of the bona fide spiritual master just to guide you, to act on the spiritual platform, then your second life begins. It is called bija. So this life is so important that one must begin it. One must begin. There is no alternative. If a man is intelligent enough, if at all he wants to make his life successful, this must he do. That is the injunction of the Vedas. The Vedas says, tad vijnanartham sa gurumeva avigachet. This avigachet is the form of bhara, which is imperative. You must. Gachet, this form of bhara is used when the sense is you must. So the Vedic Upanishad directs that tadvijnanartham, in order to be situated or in order to learn how to act on the spiritual platform, you must seek out a bona fide spiritual master who can guide. So Krishna, Arjuna has selected Krishna as the spiritual master. We have already explained that Krishna, Arjuna surrendered unto Arjuna. And now says that even after neglecting tattva sadharmam charanambujam pare. Now, Nara says that if somebody neglects all other duty, tattva sadharmam, sadharmam means every particular man has got some particular form of duty. Every particular man. He has got some duty, I have got some duty. Everyone, nobody is duty-less. Now, Narada says, even sacrificing the so-called duties, if one takes absolutely unto the spiritual life, then he is not loser. He is not loser. On the contrary, one who does not take up this important task and remain engaged in this so-called duty, he's a loser. He's a loser. Very important point. Now, Bhagavad Gita also confirms that once begun this spiritual life, then he is not loser in this sense that his human life is guaranteed in the next birth. In the ordinary duty, you do not know whether you will have again this human body or not. There is no certainty. That it depends on your quality of work. But here, if you begin your spiritual life sacrificing all other duties, then your next life as human being is guaranteed. Guaranteed. In fine Bhagavad Gita, Suchinam simatam gehe yoga bhrasta sanyasa. Bhrasta, bhrasta means one, yoga bhrasta, one who is prosecuting the yoga system. The yoga system I have already expressed. Yoga system means the transcendental process by which we realize ourselves. We link up our life with self-realization. That is called yoga. Now somebody begins this yoga of self-realization, but for unfortunately, he cannot prosecute the task in a nice way, and sometimes he falls down from the path. Still, there is encouragement that you are not loser. You are not loser. Because you will be given a chance next life. And that next life is not ordinary next life. That next life is Suchinang Simatangi. You will have your birth next life either in a very rich family or in the family of very highly advanced educated father. Suchinang Simatang. Suchinang means, I have explained to you the life of a Brahmin, Brahminical culture. The Suchi means Brahmin. Brahmins means one who knows spiritual life, how to conduct. And he has got other qualifications, so that he is called Suchi. And the opposite word of Suchi is called Muchi. So we need not explain what is Muchi. But Suchi, Suchinang means highly cultured Brahmin. And Srimata, Sri means wealth. Sri means wealth, opulence, beauty, and all these things. That means very aristocratic family. Very aristocratic fact. So he is given chance to get his birth in two places. One who is, not successful. The successful, what you speak of him? The successful goes back to Godhead, directly. And even one is unsuccessful, half finished, then he is given chance to take his birth in two kinds of families. One set is Simata. Simata means very well-to-do rich family. And other is very well polished, cultural, Brahmin family. Why? Now there is a chance. There is a chance of spiritual culture, very nicely. Of course, here in your country, aristocratic family, just like Rockefeller family or Ford family, there are many rich families here. I do not know what are their activities, but in India, the aristocratic family, they have got a particular spiritual function. Each and every aristocratic family has so many temples. So many temples. And I have already informed you that one of the aristocratic family in India, Sir Padampath Singhania, he's a very big, as we call it, your Rockefeller family. I wrote him that I want to start here one Radha Krishna temple and I want your help. Here, immediately I visit Samiji, I shall spend for a nice architectural Indian pattern temple in New York if I get an exchange sanction. So my this statement is that even up till now, Indian aristocratic family, they are so much religiously inclined that immediately on my proposal, he's agreed. He's agreed. Yes, I shall construct a temple. So that aristocratic family has the facility. And every Indian aristocratic family will find they have got their particular temples and temple worship, and they go, they offer their respects and do their business as it is. There is no harm. So side by side with material activities, they have got the chance of spiritual. Now this particular family, I am speaking to you, Singhania family, he'll be very glad to learn that how their family arrangement. They have got a temple, Dwarkadhis, Radha Krishna temple, just like this picture. They have got a very nice temple. And that temple has got some property. And that property, out of the property, one of the land is leased out to this Singhania organization business. So they pay rent to the deity. You see? So similarly, the deity has large income, and they spend also, and so many ways. If we have got the chance of starting a temple here, we shall also let you know how to spend for spiritual consciousness. Yes. Now, their family duty is that they are the Singhania, Sir Padampath Singhania, they have got four or five brothers, and the mother is still living. And the order is that each and every a family member must go every day and pay respect to the deity. And if somebody is absent one day, then he must be fined. If fine is imposed, then the big brother, Sir Padampath Singhania, if he is absent one day to pay respect to the deity, he is fined 10 rupees or $10. You see? And next day, the Brahmin or the Pujari, the worshipper and guest, he goes to collect the fine. He pays and yes, I'm sorry, yes, here is my fine. So, of course, this is self-imposed. But the idea is that they are spiritually conscious in this way. So I did not go yesterday to offer my respect to the deity, Krishna, so I must pay fine. And this is also spiritual consciousness. This is also spiritual consciousness. So the whole thing is that life should be molded in such a way that in every step of our action, we shall feel the presence of the Lord. Oh, that is spiritual life. That's it. You need not change your present occupation. That's like the example, the Singhania family. They do not change. They are doing just their order. But they are always spiritually concerned. Oh. The aim is toward Krishna. There is a very nice example. It is very ordinary, everyone will understand it. Now, suppose a man or woman is in love, and the man is a third person beyond the husband of the wife, beyond the woman. Now, it is an example given in scripture that the woman who is falling in love, the woman or man, with other woman, other man, so opposite sex. So he may be engaged in so many duties, but his mind is always to that point when he or she will meet his lover. With all his duty or her duties during the daytime, she or he always thinks, oh, when that moment will come, when we shall meet together. That means the mind is always there. The example is said because that when there is ecstasy, when there is ecstasy of love, even within the midst of our multifarious duties, we can remember that thing. Similarly, God consciousness, we shall have to mold our life in that way that in the midst of our very great duties, serious duties, we shall always remember the Sutra. The Sutra. In every step. That discrimination, that much love we have to develop. And therefore we require guide. How to develop? How to develop that? We require that. We haven't got to change anything. Let us remain in our position. But at the same time, simultaneously, side by side, let us have spiritual culture. Just like we are holding this class. This is also spiritual culture. Samanam Kirtanam. With your multifarious duties, you come here and thrice in a week and try to understand. This is also spiritual culture. This will not go in vain. This will give you impression. Even you stop coming here, that impression will never go. I tell you, that impression will never go. It is such a thing. But if we take it up very seriously and go on molding our life in that way, then it becomes quickly successful. Now suppose, if there is no loss by falling down from this path, that does not mean that we should neglect it. No. Formerly, in Medical College of Calcutta, the students who failed in the final examination, they are given some title, LMS, License in Medical and Medicine and Surgery, LMS. And those who passed, they were given the title, MD or MB, just like that. So even by failure, they would get some title and allowed to practice as medical man. But that does not mean that we may try to fail also, no. The aim should be to become successful, not to fail. Not to fail. Even though we are in failure, still there is profit, undoubtedly. But we should not aim to that object. We should be determined that in this fairy life we must have a spiritual realization perfectly, so that, as we'll find in the Bhagavad Gita, tatta viham punat janma naiti mameti kaunteya janma karma me vidvam ju janati tattataha tatta viham punat janma naiti mameti kaunteya. He Kauntya, Arjun's another name is Kauntya, because his mother's name is Kunti. Therefore, he is sometimes addressed by Krishna as Kauntya, the son of Kunti. Kauntya means the son of Kunti. So, oh, my dear son of Kunti, anyone who knows perfectly about the Lord's incarnation, why does he come? What are his activities? What is his original constitution, form, etc.? The science of God. If anyone knows, simply by knowing, a theoretical knowledge, what is his profit? Simply by knowing. Now, tatta deham punar janma naiti. Then, for him the prophet is that after giving up this body, he hasn't got to take birth again in this material form. Tatta deham punar janma naiti. Mamiti. He comes directly to me, simply by knowing. Just like you are coming here, apart from doing any practical work, if you do some practical work, it is very, very nice. Even if you do not know any practical work, simply you give your reception, oral reception, submissive oral reception, and understand that what is the nature of God, what is the nature of ourself? What is the relation between God and myself? What is this world? What is my relation with this world? So many things. Simply, if you hear and have an idea, then, even then, he'll be free from this material bondage. Tatta viham punat janma naiti mami hi kauntya. Therefore, as Lord Krishna says, that durina javaram kanma buddhi juga dhananjaya buddhau saranam adnicha kripana phalahetava. Don't be miser. We have already explained in our last meeting what is the miser and what is the brahmin. The opposite word is dharm. Miser means this valuable body, who does not properly utilize it. Simply, they utilize this body for sense gratification and nothing more. They are kripana. Kripana means miser. Miser, who does not utilize the asset given to him, is a miser. Miser is not liberal. One should be liberal. There is a Pandit, learned man, his name is Chanakya. Some of you had been in India, in New Delhi, where foreign ambassadors are settled in New Delhi, capital of India, and there is a quarter which is called Chanakya Puri. This Chanakya Puri has been named due to the name of this gentleman, Chanakya. He was a great politician and prime minister during the reign of Emperor Chandragupta. Long years before. He was a great politician. So his politics had studied in her MA class. And so he has got a book which is called Chanakya Shloka, and some principles of morality. Some principles of morality. And we, in our childhood, we had to study that small book, Chanakya Shloka. So in that principles of morality, even Chanakya Pandit says that sannimitti varanatyaga vinase niyate sati. Vinase niyate sati. This body is destined to be destroyed. You cannot protect it. It is to be destroyed. Sannimitte varanta vinase. Vinase means it is sure to be destroyed, as sure as death. There is nothing sure as death. Therefore, this body should be utilized, sannimitte, for purpose of spiritual realization. Before it is finished, in all these chapters, this is their life. This is their life. The dog's body will be finished, and the man's body will be finished. But what is the difference of dog and man? The dog does not know how to utilize his body, but we are giving instruction in so many books of knowledge how to utilize this body. So Chanakya Pandit says that sannimitta barantyaga. You have to give up this body. Why don't you give it up? For the highest cause. Highest cause. This is the highest cause. Spiritual death. Somebody is offering his body for country's cause. Somebody is offering body for the society's cause. Or somebody is offering body for theft case or some murdering case. Everyone has to offer his body at the end. But the man who sacrifices this body for the purpose of self-realization, he is the most intelligent man. Sannimitti varanatyaga vinase nihatisati. You will have to meet death, undoubted. But before meeting death, as fully spiritualized. That is the instruction there. Buddho saranam in annicca. Kripala, don't be miser. Don't misuse this great opportunity. Buddhi yukto jahatiha ubhe sukrita duskrite tasmad yogaya jiggasya yoga karmasu kausalam. Yoga karmasu kausalam. Kausalam means expert trick. Just like there are two men working. One man is very expert. Another man is not so expert. Even in machinery, when there is something wrong in the machine, the man who is not very expert, he's trying whole day, night, how to adjust it. But the expert comes and at once sees what is the defect and he joins one where this one, that one, and making the difference. Just like sometimes we find difficulty in our this tape recorder. Mr. Carl and somebody comes and rectifies this. So everything requires some expert knowledge. So karma. Karma means what? We have to work. Without watching, even our this body and soul cannot go. It is a very misconception for one who is for spiritual realization, he hasn't got to work. No, he has got to work more. Persons who are not for spiritual realization, they may be engaged in work for 8 hours only. But those who are engaged for spiritual realization, they are engaged 24 hours. 24 hours. That is the difference. And that difference is, you will find, that on the material platform, on the bodily conception of life, if you work for 8 hours only, you will feel fatigued. But spiritual purpose, if you work more than 24 hours, unfortunately you haven't got more than 24 hours at your disposal, still you won't feel fatigued. I kill. This is my practical experience. This is my practical experience. All is working. Something reading or writing. 24 hours. Simply when I feel hungry, I take some food. And simply when I feel asleep, I go to bed. Otherwise, always I don't feel fatigue. You can ask Mr. Paul whether I'm not doing it. So I take pleasure in doing that. I don't feel fatigue. Similarly, when one will have that spiritual sense, he won't feel, rather he'll feel disgusted to go to sleep. Sleep has come, just to this time. See, he wants to lessen the time of sleeping. As we pray, Bande Rupa Sanatana Raghujigo, Sri Jiva Gopalako. These six Gosamins, they were deputed by Lord Chaitanya to discuss this science. They have written immense literature about it, you see. So, you'll be surprised that they were sleeping only for 1.5 hours daily. Not more than that. That also sometimes they forego. They're so much busy in spiritual activities. Krishna, Kirtana, Gana, Nartana. So spiritual life is so sublime and so invigorating that you won't feel fatigued. You have to be engaged. And as you are engaged actually in spiritual life, you won't feel fatigued. You will be fearless. And your life will be always blissful. These are the symptoms. The yoga karmasu kousalam. The Lord says that this spiritual platform is the karmasu kousalam. Kousalam means expert service. Expert kousalam. Kusal. Kusal means auspicious. And from kusal, it comes to kousal. That means if you learn the trick how to work on the platform of yoga, then that is the highest technique of doing work. Buddhi yuktoja. And a result of that work, what is that? The buddhi yukta. When you work from the spiritual platform with your intelligence, then jahati yaha ubhe sukrita duskrita. Sukrita duskrita. Now, for ordinary work, if you do good work, then you have to take good result. And if you do bad work or sinful work, then you have to take the effect of such bad and sinful work. Sukrita and duskrita. But one who works from spiritual platform, he hasn't got to take the result of good work or bad work. Because he is transcendent. He has no good work or no bad work. Everything transcendental work. Just I take the example of Arjuna. He was thinking that fighting of this nature is not good for me. That was his problem. Because he was thinking on the bodily platform, the same Arjuna again took to fighting. Does it mean that by understanding Bhagavad Gita, he took to bad work? No. Just try to understand. He declined to fight. He thought that fighting for me with my relatives is not good. That was his conclusion. And actually, from material platform, suppose you two brothers who are going to fight for something, and if third person comes, if he advises that you are two brothers, why you are fighting, have it amicably settled, and that is good, actually. But Arjuna, from practical point of view, or from the materialistic point of view, he was good, that he was declining to fight. And Lord Krishna was inducing him to fight. So does it mean that Lord Krishna was inducing him to the bad course? No. He was inducing him to a course which is beyond good and bad, transcendent. From the material platform, even if you do good work, then that is also not good. That is also not good. Now, according to scriptures, now, one who does good work only, no sinful work, then what is the result of his good work? Oh, he gets birth in a good family, in a higher planet, or very rich man, or very educated man, very beautiful man. These are the result of good work. Janma isajya sutta 3. Four things are obtained by good work. You get very good birth, high parentage, janma. You get very good wealth in a wealthy family, or you earn millions and millions of dollars. You don't think that simply by laboring one can earn millions and millions of dollars, unless he has got in the background very good work. Otherwise everyone is trying to earn millions and billions, but somebody is earning very quickly without any effort, and somebody whole life working, he does not get sufficient for his maintenance. So these are the results of good one and bad one. So janma isajya sutta, high education, to become very highly learned man, that is also due to good work. And to be very beautiful, that is also a result of good work. Janma is just sutta sri. Sri means beauty. And bad work is just opposite. Now, good work or bad work? Now, when you take your birth in a good family, when you are very much educated, very much beautiful, but still you have to accept the triple miseries of material existence. That you cannot avoid. Because you are very rich man, you cannot avoid your death, you cannot avoid your disease, you cannot avoid your old age. Similarly, as the man who is poor man, he also cannot avoid old age, he cannot avoid death, he cannot avoid disease. Similarly, the troubles of material existence is there, both in good life and bad life. But when you work transcendentally, neither good nor bad, for the sake of the Supreme Consciousness, transcendental position, you don't get this material birth at all, therefore, that is real good. You are above this birth, death, old age, and so many troubles, miseries of life. Lord Sri Krishna says that buddhi yukto jahati, if you work from the transcendental plane or spiritual platform, then you get rid of all the results of good work and bad work. Don't be attached by either by good work or bad work. That is the technique. A transcendentalist who wants to work from spiritual platform, he has no botheration whether I am doing good or bad. He has only to see whether I am acting on the platform of spiritual consciousness or material consciousness. That's all. Even apparently bad work by such person on the spiritual consciousness is also good, supreme good. Not only good, but supreme good. Just like you say the example of Arjuna. From material point of view, he was right that it is not good to fight with my brothers. That is right, from material point of view. But when he learned Bhagavad Gita, he fought with the same brothers. With the same brothers. That means that after learning Bhagavad Gita, after taking lessons of Bhagavad Gita, he did not become a bad man. No, he became a transcendental man. Transcendental man. Because that fighting he accepted on the instruction, on the desire of the Supreme Consciousness, Krishna. Oh, that is the thing. Similarly, when we mold our life in such a way that we have to act on the direction of the Supreme Consciousness, then our life becomes sublime, spiritual. Now, as I have already explained to you, that we require a guide. We require a guide. That guide should be the representative of Krishna. Otherwise, he cannot be guide. Just like Krishna was the guide of Arjuna directly. Now, here we haven't got Krishna directly, but how to have a guide? That guide means he must be a representative of Krishna. Representative of Krishna. How one can become representative of Krishna? That means one who follows the instruction of Krishna. Right? Just like you take for example a lawyer. What do you mean by lawyer? One who understands the law books very nicely. He is a lawyer. A representative of law. Similarly, here in the Bhagavad Gita, there are instructions of Krishna, and a person who understands these instructions rightly. How to understand that instruction rightly? That is also in this book. You haven't got to seek and elsewhere how to understand Bhagavad Gita. How to understand Bhagavad Gita is already prescribed here. That I shall explain to you. When you go to the fourth chapter, now we are on the second chapter, when you go to the fourth chapter, how to understand Bhagavad Gita, that is also mentioned there. So according to that process, if somebody understands Bhagavad Gita and in his life he practices in that way, just like a lawyer who has passed the law examination, similarly, one who understands Bhagavad Gita as it is, without any wishful interpretation for his own purpose. No. Bhagavad Gita as it is instructed to Arjuna. If there is somebody who understands Bhagavad Gita in that way, he is the representative of God. He is the representative of Krishna. And one should accept such representative of Krishna for his guide, then actually as much as Arjuna was guided by Krishna, then similarly that person who takes the shelter of the guidance of if a person who is fully aware, fully conversant with the science of Krishna, he can guide you nicely and for your spiritual life, as Lord Krishna has guided Arjuna for his spiritual life. Thank you very much.